Hello and welcome. My name is Tracy, and this is part one of a tutorial on how to convert a single-player AR game into a multiplayer game using the ConjureKit SDK by Aoki Labs, which allows for instant calibration between devices into the same AR session. The game was made by my colleague Romy and was first released as a Halloween-themed demo, so it features ghosts and pumpkins that spawn at a distance and fly towards the players, and the player's objective is to shoot them before getting hit. For the purpose of this tutorial, we've created a repo on GitHub with several commits corresponding to the different chapters of the tutorial, from the initial project setup, which is the game in single-player mode, to the finished game with multiplayer features powered by the ConjureKit. In this video, we'll cover the first half of the tutorial, which goes through ConjureKit implementation and message broadcasting to all participants with the Vikia module. Before you begin, please make sure you've gone through the Quick Start Guide linked here. You'll need to create an account on the Aoki Labs console if you don't already have one, add an app, and save your app key and app secret. You'll also need to configure your development environment so it can access the Aoki Labs scoped registry. All of these steps are covered in detail in the Quick Start Guide. Let's get started by cloning the project from GitHub. Then navigate to that directory and git check out the initial project setup commit. Open the project in Unity. And click Ignore when it asks you to enter safe mode. It's complaining because it's missing these dependencies. Once the project is open, go ahead and add these assets. They're already in my assets, so I'll just import them into the project. You'll have to go through a quick setup process for .tween here by clicking this green button. Click Apply, and that's it. The game scene is here in the Scenes folder. And you can click Play to try it out. If you want, you can also build it to your device. You'll see a missing project ID dialog, but just click Yes to continue. Here's a short clip of the game in single player mode. But of course, games are more fun when played together, so let's get started with the ConjureKit implementation. Back in Unity, open the Package Manager to view the packages in the project. The ones we need should already be installed. Now in the Tutorials folder, find Scripts and open main.cs. Add these using statements. Next, we'll declare these fields, which will hold references to ConjureKit and its modules. These two will keep track of the AR session and its current state. We'll initialize the ConjureKit modules. Paste these lines here into the beginning of the start method. And ConjureKit.connect goes at the end. Make sure you also paste in your app key and app secret from the Aoki Labs console. Now we'll create event init. This subscribes all the methods we'll need to their respective events from ConjureKit. On joined, on left, on participant left, on entity deleted, on participant entity created, on state change, on lighthouse tracked, and on calibration success. Of course, we'll have to declare these same 8 methods next. The onJoined and onStateChange methods will update the session ID and session state in the UI, so let's go to uimanager.cs and add the set session ID and update state methods. With these declared, we can go back to main.cs and call them in onJoined and onStateChange. By the way, the session ID and the session state appear here in the game's UI. Now we can run the project, and you'll see here that it connects to a session and displays the session ID. So far, so good. In this next part, we'll use the Vicu module to broadcast messages to all participants in the session. Messages in this case are game start or game over events, as well as changes to the position of the beam that spawns the ghosts and pumpkins. Naturally, for a multiplayer game, we want the game state and spawner position to be synchronized across all players. We can go ahead and copy this entire script. In the gameplay folder, create a new C# script called GameEventController and paste in the whole class definition. These are references to ConjureKit and Vicia. Notify game state and notify spawner pose are used as identifiers for game state notifications and spawner pose updates. These three define actions that will be triggered on game over, game start, and spawner move events. The initialize method sets up the game event controller with instances of ConjureKit and Vicia and subscribes methods to these events. Send game state and send spawner pose use Vicia to broadcast messages about the game state and spawner pose updates. And we also have methods for setting the entity ID of the participant and handling different types of entity actions like game state changes and spawner pose updates. So this is the bulk of the Vicia implementation, which allows anyone in the session to broadcast messages about the game state and spawner pose to all other participants. Now let's instantiate it in main.cs. And initialize it in the start method. Then we'll assign the game start and game over callbacks in the onJoined method. Now we need to define a few more things. A private bool called spawner. The sendGameStart method. And the sendGameOver method. We'll remove onGameStart.invoke from the GameStart method, since it's invoked in sendGameStart now. Scroll up to the start method and pass sendGameStart into the UIManager.initialize call instead of GameStart. And whenever a player dies, we want to call sendGameOver instead of GameOver. Since we implemented a method to broadcast spawner pose updates, let's remove this line in the placeSpawner method and replace it with GameEventController.sendSpawnerPose. And we'll copy and paste these lines into the EventInit method. Now whenever a participant changes the spawner position, Vicia will broadcast this to all participants in the session, and everyone will see it correctly in its new position. Lastly, we should call GameOver when we've left a session. In order to toggle the QR code, which we call a lighthouse in ConjureKit, we'll add a method for that. And we'll pass this method into UIManager.initialize. So now let's test it. I'll build the project to a phone and use the Unity editor as the second participant. Scan the QR code, and when the session IDs match, that's how I know both devices are in the same session. Now if I press play on one device, the game starts for both. At this point, only the one device sees the ghosts and pumpkins because we haven't synchronized those yet. That will be part two of this tutorial. For now, what we've accomplished is that the game starts and ends at the same time for both players. And also, if I place the spawner somewhere else like this, its position gets updated on the other device too. That's it for part one. Next time we'll use the Entity Component System, or ECS, to sync the Ghosts and Pumpkins, the VFX, and the scores in order to complete the upgrade to a multiplayer game. Thanks so much for following along, and stay tuned for the next video. In the meantime, please join our Discord server for ConjureKit SDK support, or just to show us what you're building. See you there, and thanks again!